to Battleground Canada now and our focus on the four by-elections that we are going to see across this country this fall. One of those by-elections precipitated by the retirement from politics of the longtime MP from Provencher, Vic Toews, who joins us now from Winnipeg. And I'm so used to saying minister, but I'm going to call you Vic now that you're sort of out of it. Are you going to, first of all, I guess this is going to be your first fall in a long time where you're not going to have to be sitting just a few blocks away from me in the House of Commons. Are you going to miss it at all?
Not at all. It's a wonderful fall here in Winnipeg. I just live on the edge of the city, and I'm just enjoying every moment of it.
All right. Well, let's talk a little politics, because a guy named Justin Trudeau, who you, of course, know pretty well, was in the riding of Brandon-Souris yesterday. He was in your old riding today. I think he's got an event as well tonight. He's trying to raise some awareness for Liberals. Let me ask you about Provencher, riding you know very, very, very well. Do the Liberals have a hope here?
Well, they got 6% in the last election. They never had gone that low. It was our intention to put them into third place, and that's where we put them. 6% is a pretty far distance to come back from if you're going to have any hopes of winning a riding like Provencher. But it's more than just the numbers. It's the policies that Justin Trudeau is in fact advocating or not advocating. People in that riding are fairly sharp. They know when they're getting the runaround, when somebody's not giving them the straight goods. And Trudeau, I think true to form, has been basically saying nothing in the hopes that he can sort of glide through these ridings. Brandon-Souris and Provencher will be very difficult for him to do that.
In Brandon-Souris, the Liberal candidate is a guy named Rolf Dinsdale. He's coming under some fire today for a couple of things. One, his biography says he was a senior executive at Facebook. In fact, it turns out he never worked for Facebook, just for a company that Facebook hired. So there's one thing. You're fudging the biography. But then there's something else. He's in a punk rock band with the friend of Sun News Network, with Warren Kinsella. And they have a video out that a lot of Christians were definitely going to find offensive. I'm wondering if that kind of thing is going to go over very well with the good people of Brandon-Souris.
Well, I haven't seen the video myself. I think the real issue with Mr. Dinsdale is that the Liberals had to import a candidate from Toronto to run in Brandon-Souris. That is going to be a much greater difficulty. There's no accounting for bad taste in music, and some people like punk rock, some people don't. I have friends who do, but I don't think that's going to be the biggest issue. Certainly the messaging, if it's offensive to some of the hardcore beliefs of individuals in those ridings, is going to concern some. But I think the big issue that he's going to have to overcome is the fact that he virtually has no connection with the riding. It was much like the Liberals back in 2004, brought a Toronto lawyer to run against me by the name of Epp, again playing on the name of the former MP. They thought people would somehow think they were associated or related. The big issue was that he really had no connections, not even with the riding, but with the province.
Now, Vic, of course, during most of your career, you were what's called the regional minister for Manitoba, so your leader looked to you for political advice for the province. I want to get your thoughts, as there's sort of been a bit of a generational change here with you and Merv Tweed resigning and Shelley Glover now sort of stepping in that role. Give me your sense as parties are getting set up for 2015. I'm assuming the New Democrats are primarily the threat in a lot of parts of the province to conservatives.
The New Democrats do have a couple of seats in Manitoba. We were able to beat them in the long stronghold of Elmwood Transcona. Lawrence Towat won that riding. He's been a very strong MP. The NDP are going to have a rough job in trying to win that seat back. But by and large, I think what's going to happen is that there's going to be a bit of pushback from the provincial NDP. They've run onto some hard times here in Manitoba, and they're going to have to work very hard federally to disassociate themselves with some of the concerns that have been raised about the provincial NDP. The federal and provincial NDP do work hand in glove, and that's going to be a challenge for them.
And you know that federal NDP leader Thomas Mulcair has often held up Premier Greg Salinger, the premier there, as an example of how the NDP can be good governors. But I'm sure conservatives would like to have Salinger's record tied to Mulcair's.
Well, I think it might be a mistake at this time for Mulcair to hold up the record of Mr. Salinger. Mr. Salinger is the premier. He's had to make some decisions which some individuals feel he went back on his word in terms of tax increases and the like. And so that is going to be a challenge for the federal NDP, who, as I say, work very closely with their provincial cousins in Manitoba.
Well, Vic Toews, former public safety minister, longtime MP for Provencher, thank you so much for joining us. And let's have you back on the program soon.
You bet, David. All the best to you.